Good afternoon, class. I am Anand Pandey from Mechanical Department. Today we will learn the subject Mechanical Measurement and Control. In that subject, we are going to learn module number 2. In previous lecture, we have learned about displacement measurement transducer. Okay? In that displacement measurement transducer, we have learned about what is transducer. Transducer is a device which convert one form of energy into another form. Okay? So in that in last lecture we have seen LDT. What LDT did? What is the function of LDT? LDT convert change in voltage or change in EMF into displacement. Change in displacement into change in voltage. Okay. So that we have to calculate. And that is our task for LDT. Okay. So in that case we are going to learn another transducer, that is potentiometer. Okay. In potentiometer. Potentiometer they might be called as a quad, POT quad. Okay? So today's point of discussion is the potentiometer. Here we are going to plot in initial voltage. Okay, this is our resistance wire. This is our resistance wire that is mounted on this rod, which is insulated. Okay, then this is our wiper. Voltage substitute coil that having some resistance that is bonded on this particularly rounded shaft. Okay, and we are here measuring change in output voltage EO. Okay, so as that angular, let us suppose that this is angular, some angular 30 degree, that angle 30 degree it changes to 30 degree to 60 degree. Let us suppose that this wiper it changes to 60 degree, means it will show you maximum resistance, okay, compared to earlier. Okay, so that is indicated change in angle theta. Okay, so mainly that resistive body is made up of platinum, made up of platinum material, okay, or sometimes nickel alloy, and it is having diameter of maximum 0.01 mm. It is having maximum diameter of 0.01 mm. Okay, and this is resistive coil. This resistive coil is made up of mainly cement, okay, or carbon material. This is made up of cement or carbon material. Okay, so with high resistance. Okay, now it is all about AC. Now let us move to the DC. DC excitation potentiometer. DC excitation potentiometer are having construction similar to the AC excitation potentiometer. We know that potentiometer principle of potentiometer is change in resistance will give you change in displacement. Okay, change in distance. So this is wiper. This is ER. This is EO. This is wiper. This is distance x I, this is distance xt. Xt is the total distance. Xt denotes xt is equal to total distance. And this is displacement by wiper. Displacement by wiper E I. Okay. When you measure change in output voltage, will give you ratio of output voltage divided by input voltage, which equals to wiper displacement divided by total distance. Okay, EO divided by EI is equal to XI divided by XT. Okay, so we can write as a wiper displacement divided by total length. Okay, so similar to the angular measurement. Okay, in angular measurement we can measure angle to the 3500 degree. Okay, is it possible 3500 degree? No, correct, because maximum it is 90 degree, it is 180 degree. This 180 degree, this 270 degree, this 360 degree. Okay, but we can measure 3500 degree by using heliport. Okay, so we are making some changes to the rotational potentiometer by using heliport. Okay, so in that case we are increasing number of turns. Of rotational potentiometer like this. Okay, so by using same principle we can use up to 3500 degree, and this assembly is known as the heliport. Okay, so here increase number of pumps. Okay, up to 3500. Okay, so this assembly is known as the heliport. Okay, then it's come to sensitivity. As you know, output divided by input. Okay, when we are providing some input to the minor input to the instrument, the tremendous changes it will give you. Tremendous changes means that instrument is more sensitive. Okay, so in that case, potentiometer also, if we are giving minor displacement as an input, that changes in voltage, the changes in resistance will give you sensitivity of potentiometer. So this potential